हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज आवर थर्ड सेशन, द थर्ड ऑनलाइन सेशन फॉर द सब्जेक्ट ऑफ इंडस्ट्रियल सेफ्टी। दिस सब्जेक्ट इज फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स ऑफ सिविल इंजीनियरिंग एंड मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, एंड हियर दे विल बी डिस्कसिंग ऑल द टॉपिक्स दैट इज रिक्वायर्ड टू बी कंप्लीटेड एज पर जीटीयू सिलेबस। सो द टॉपिक्स that are covered in this session, this online session, will be in synchronization with the GTU syllabus. So we have already done the two sessions of digital safety. The first was the introductions. Then next session we have discussed regarding the mechanical hazard. So today we will be proceeding with our next topics in of the industrial safety. Okay. So this basically we are in module 1 only, and we have completed few topics. We will be proceeding. Yeah. This is the most main thing that is causing the electrical damage. That is the jump from the ground wire to the neutral. And if the neutral circuit becomes corroded, means we can say that the circuit is getting corroded or loose, and the voltage on the ground will get increases to a dangerous level. And because of this, dangerous accidents used to take place. Insulation failure. So mainly insulations are required provided in the circuit, but due to many reasons it can get damaged. The degradation of the insulation can cause the base wire and the resulting shock to anyone coming in contact. So once it has got failure, and the person who is coming in contact with that circuit where the insulation failure used to take place can get a shock. And the main reasons is the environmental toxin. Because of the environmental, the insulation failure will take place. Main reasons are direct sunlight. When the direct sunlight falls on the insulator, because of the high temperature, it can get damaged. Sparks. So because of some short circuit used to take a health set to have occurred on that circuit, and because of these sparks, the insulation failure can also take place. Repeated exposure to elevated temperature means we can say that when regularly the high temperature has occurred in the circuit, because of this, the insulation failure can take place. Safety precautions for the electrical hazards. So there are some safety precautions that is required to be taken care while dealing with electrical equipment or electrical hazard. Ensure that the power has to be disconnected from the system before working with it. So person who has key to maintain or to repair the equipment should check only when the equipment is properly disconnected from the electricity. Capacitors can store for and after the power has been. So even the capacitors can use to have the power. So they used to take care while repairing or maintaining. Allow only the authorized and the trained people to work. So the person who has proper knowledge regarding the subject, we can say that regarding the electricity, theoretical equipment, and who get what the proper training for repairing or the dealing with the equipment should only be called for the maintenance or the repairing. Do not wear any kind of conductive material such as jewelry. So a person who is dealing with the electrical equipment should never wear a conductor. He should wear non-conductor, for example rubber or timber. Means he should have some material with him so that insulation will take place. Periodically inspect the insulation. The insulation wire should be properly or periodically inspected, because with the help of the means with the rise in the temperature or any other kind of source of heat, it might have got damage. If the insulations have got damage, then there is a chance of the occurrence of the shock. So it is necessary that it is required to be periodically inspected so that if the maintenance is required, it should be done. If the working on the hot circuit use the body system and wear the protective. So when working with the hot system, it is necessary to wear the protective clothing so that the person will not get damaged. Do not use the fuse with a greater capacity than prescribed. So it is necessary to use the optimum capacity fuse. Verify the circuit voltage before performing the work. So it is necessary to verify the circuit voltage before doing any kind of work regarding the circuit. Do not use water to put on electrical. So because of during the work, because of any kind of reason, the spark can take place. Because of the spark, fire can also. So in order to stop that fire, it is not required to use water. It can be stopped by any other ways, but it is necessary that water should not be put on the electrical fire. Or means we can say that wire should never be used on the electrical fire. Discharge capacitors before working on the equipment. It is necessary to discharge the equipment before working with the equipment, because we have discussed earlier also that capacitors has the electric current even after the power has got shut it off. It is necessary to discharge the capacitor before working with it, because the electricity which is present in that capacitor, it also get removed. Use fuses and circuit breakers for the protection. So such kind of circuits, fuses or circuit breakers is required for protection from the excessive current. Okay. So this is the our topic of the electrical hazards, where we have discussed the reason behind the electrical hazards, the places where the electrical hazard used to take place, and what are the precautions that is required to be taken. These are the all general things that is required to be done so that the hazard or accidents or shock will not happen. As a result, the life of the personnel and the life of the equipment will also be maintained, and it can achieve the design life. So by doing this, all things proper electrical hazard can be. This is our topic. Thank you for attending the session.